Now close your eyes, now stop your crying. When you stop crying, you will sleep. No, don't fear it, for it is kind. And when you awake, your father's away, his meaning is lost in an enemy land. No one is safe. Oh, how I miss him at night when I hear the young lover next door serenade his new bride. Oh, how I miss him in the middle of a dream, our flesh in the sunlight surrounded by love. Now close your eyes, now stop your crying. When you stop crying, you will sleep. No, don't fear it, for it is kind. And when you awake, I'm tired of the noise made by my fear. The guns of darkness roar in my ear. When your father was here, we painted this room. We laughed as we worked. He treated me kind. Yes, he treated me kind and cared for my ways. He was tender, gentle, you were made with our love. Good night, young quietly across the clear river. Now pass over the floating hills. No, don't fear it, for it is coming. No, don't fear, it's all.
And I can heal you. Yet there's nothing but his crying, and the blood is flowing freely from a door exploded out of his heart. Don't worry, I try to tell him while he babbles into his pillow. I'm a nurse and I can heal you. Yet there's nothing but his crying, his hands haunt the air, his eyes are wounded by the battle.
I'm a nurse and I can heal, I'm a nurse and I can heal, I'm a nurse and I can heal, yet there's nothing, yet there's nothing.
You'll be fine in the morning, I tell him as he cries. Help, help, help me, I'm alone. I'm a nurse and I can heal you, but I cannot take your hand and lead you on to the heavenly city. Everything is checked out, the doctor's on his way. No more paradox to reveal. But his body breaks apart, his head explodes in flowers. Yet there is nothing but his crying.
I'm a nurse and I can heal. I'm a nurse and I can heal. I'm a nurse and I can heal. Yet there's nothing. Yet there's nothing. Yet there's nothing.
Confessing. In the afternoon, waiting for somebody to pick me up. I've never liked to wait. This year I've wasted much time waiting for people to come here. Belief in the arbitrary symbols of time distract from enlightenment, and I have distracted myself from enlightenment for too many years now to be distracted by my habits. I had planned this to be the beginning of a novel I've always wanted to write. In my mind, it would be a simple business. I could see the finished typescript, leaf through it. But it is something that would have to be done one Sunday afternoon. A casual creation like catching a line drive one-handed, and in a circular motion taking the ball from the mitt and tossing it back to the pitcher. Then in late afternoon to gather twilight dreams from the shadows, to light a favorite pipe, smoke, read through the day's novel, all 365 pages of it. Everybody plays the radio on Sunday, and all the windows are open, and all of the musics get tangled in the cherry trees, moving with the wind. Through these years, I've talked about moments with my friend Peter LeBlanc, the painter. We sit in a coffee shop drinking Italian coffee, talking about moments. Or we sit in a bar drinking wine or beer. Or when there's some extra money, we'll drink Bloody Marys or Mexican beer or Spanish sherry or Ficklin's Port from California and talk about moments. Moments in the making of a picture, a poem. Moments in the act of love, moments between people when something beyond the expected happens. Moments inside a man when he's made to realize that a moment is gone. We've been tracking moments for years, Peter in his way and I in my fashion. You know, it takes a lot of coffee and a lot of wine and a lot of money and a lot of time.
Thank you. Do you think I'd forget your sweet belly of love and the lovely children that grew there? Do you think I'd forget your sweet soft mouth and the joys of our love that I found there? Do you think I'd forget? Do you think I'd forget? Do you think I'd forget? I want to thank you again and again for the rest of our time together on earth or in heaven again and again to thank you for letting me love you. Do you think I'd forget? Do you think I'd forget? Do you think I'd forget? Do you think in the night when we return to the loving our bodies move? Our children will someday know this joy, and their love will renew the earth. Do you think they'd forget? Do you think they'd forget? Do you think they'd forget?
For the mind.
into a dream. Laugh at when you can, him to love. A direct and simple, yes. My first love was a soldier. He took my body's gait. He left me bloody on the clover, looking into the sky, looking into the sky to dream of a new love, moving through.
Thank you.
I'm in my room writing, speaking in myself, and I hear you move down the hallway to water your plants. I write truth on the page. I strike the word over and over. Yet I worry you'll pour too much water on the plants, and the water will overflow onto the books, ruining them. If I can't speak out of myself, how can I tell you I don't care about the plants? How can I tell you I don't care if the books get wet? We've been together 7 years, and only now do I begin clearing my throat to speak to you.
His ghost will touch my flesh with love beyond my knowing and dreams beyond my reach. What dream does he have at dawn? Birds surround us with their song of Earth's green.
groans and sounds in his sleep. What dream does he have at dawn?
I'm afraid of the flowers, she said. They move so quietly. Vines on the bed table, roses on the dresser, awaken at night as my breath awaits love to come move my room. The flowers turn, breathe as they move towards me in the dark, large shadows. I'm afraid of the breath the flowers have, she said. Tonight, full moon, I watch without sleep, so quietly do they move upon me.